It's his strongest attribute. The Pelicans will try and defend their Smoothie King Center nest tonight against the Spurs, who are an outstanding 20-4 on the road this year. Anthony Davis is listed as probable for the game as he's dealing with a thigh bruise. The Birds could use his help as they've lost 5 straight meetings against San Antonio. Today at 4 on WWL, join Deuce McAllister and Christian Garrick live from Mobile, Alabama for a Senior Bowl edition of Fans in the Pro. Which players might be a good fit for the Saints, and which LSU Tigers should the Black and Gold target in the draft? Steve Geller, WWL Sports. Channel 4 meteorologist Dave Nussbaum is in the 10-point forecast center.
Winds are finally returned to the New Orleans area with more cool weather today under partly cloudy skies and a high around 56. For tonight, look for mostly cloudy skies. We'll be on the cold side with lows north of the lake into the mid-30s with some patchy frost to protect those plants and pets in south of the lake in the lower 40s. Heading into Saturday, the clouds continue to stick around for much of the day, making it mostly cloudy. Stays cool with a high around 57, but sunshine returns on Sunday. We'll be breezy and cool in the wake of a dry front that's going to move through. High temperatures will be in the upper 50s. For the Midpoint Forecast Center, I'm WWL-TV meteorologist Dave Nussbaum.
North wind 12 miles per hour, gust up to 20, humidity 60%. It's 45 and partly cloudy at New Orleans Armstrong International Airport. Clear skies, 36 degrees north of the lake. Time to check out WWL traffic.
And the WWL traffic center, I'm Terrell Robinson. Just now getting, looking at accident on the lakebound Pontchartrain Expressway. Going to be near O'Keefe. Left central lane is blocked. And police been on the scene there. And your delays are across the Crescent City connection between Stump and Lafayette. That's the respective of a slowdown coming off to the East Bank side. Crescent City connection. The trip across the CUNY Long Bridge is still around 90B West Bank Expressway, but it looks to be improving now. From LaPlace, Bonnet Carey, Spillway, Treat, Newell, getting it through Kenner. Patch is going around Power Boulevard. You really don't hit it, hit the slowdown ticket between Clearview and Causeway, and that will be all the way into the CBD. Problem free on the Causeway, over Lake Pontchartrain. Here from Slidell looks good. Earlier action, your shuffling tour out of the way. And this graphic report brought to you by Beautyrest.
The Beautyrest Platinum mattress brings you innovative design and superior style. With Beautyrest Platinum, it's not about finding the right setting. It's about elegantly orchestrated sleep. Enjoy precision and control with the Beautyrest Platinum sleep system.
Now drive to tip on WWL 504-260-INFO.
Thanks, Terrell. I'm Chris Miller for WWL First News. Here's Bob Mitchell on WWL AMFM.com.
Thank you, Chris. It's 8 minutes after 8 o'clock. Welcome back to the show. As you drive to work this morning, we're talking about Donald Trump's first week in office. After his first week in office, do you think President Trump is doing a good job, yes or no? Anything really excited you or anything really scared you? We have been talking off and on about some of the demonstrations, some of the anti-Trump demonstrations. Let me read this text message. And this really does kind of say it all. And if I gave you the wrong impression, fact check keeps me from giving you the wrong impression. I did not mean to. Please, please get your facts straight. A few protesters before Trump's inauguration rioted. 2.5 million people protested peacefully the day after Trump's inauguration. If I said anything other than that, it's not what I meant. The majority of the protesters were very peaceful protesters, but a handful does something like breaks windows and sets fire to someone's car. I would call that a riot. Maybe it should be a mini riot or what? A bad demonstration, an arson. But the majority of the protesters were very peaceful, and that's the way it should be. However, when you do something like you burn someone's car down, you destroy someone's personal property, my opinion is you should be arrested and put in jail. All right, let's go to Lonnie in La Paz. Lonnie, how are you?
I'm okay this morning.
You are in favor of the law?
Yeah, in a way, I am in favor of the law because we need to keep our people out here in this country employed. And not have people come and teach a job and work for me and while our family is suffering all the health tax from that. And as far as what the job Donald Trump is doing, I'm think Peaceful Service campaign promises, and he's showing that the United States will not back down and will not be interrogated or will not be listened. And he's showing that he's going to be a good leader. What happened in the future, I don't know, but right now he's showing leadership, and that's what we need in this country.
That's kind of where I am. I think he's doing a good job. He seems to be leading. He seems to be trying to accomplish all the campaign promises that he said he was going to. And so many presidents do not do that. So many presidents say, well, maybe we could accomplish these things the first term, but it's going to take a second term to accomplish this. So from that standpoint, but it's going to be months. I want to see how things are going 6 months from now. I want to see what happens when some international leader insults him or he can't get his way. That's what I'm waiting to see.
The main thing that I'm waiting to see is a lot of people don't understand in this country is that I'm waiting to see if Donald Trump can do something for the last 12 years that other presidents were unable to do. And that was to unite this country as a whole, as individuals coming together. Because, you know, defend the Constitution of the United States of America and include the people in this country also. And I think that as a country, as a whole, we need to back him, support him, no matter what, because we voted him in and we need to help him. And let him get a chance to see what he can do. We give Obama a chance for 8 years to country right now at home.
All right, Lonnie, thank you so very much. Do you agree with Lonnie? Something we keep talking about. Time to back off and just give the man a chance. 260-1870. It's 12 minutes after 8 o'clock.
This hour of WWL First News with Tommy Tucker is brought to you by Desk of Louisiana. Don't let neck or back pain keep you sidelined.
Show me free money! It's the final day this week. You can win $1,000 free money on WWL. Listen to the code word right before 7 a.m., 11 a.m., 2 p.m., and 5 p.m. Text that word to 72881 every weekday. Four lucky listeners nationwide win $1,000. Listen right before 7-Eleven, 2 and 5. Take home free money. $1,000. $1,000. From Smart Radio Intercom and WWL. We never charge for text, but individual plan text and data rates apply.
Ryan Family of Dealerships continues 60 years of treating customers right with quality vehicles. This month at Ryan Subaru, get an incredible 0% financing on all 2017 Subaru Outbacks. Complimentary maintenance on all new vehicles for 2 years included. Cannot be combined with any other incentive. Financing for well-qualified applicants only. Subject to credit approval, no down payment required. See dealer for details. Promotion ends January 31, 2017.
Seagull Serenading is the sunsets on the lake, and the best local seafood you'll find anywhere. The Blue Crab Restaurant and Oyster Bar brings it all back. Fresh salty oysters on half shell, stuffed flounder, seafood platters, and other New Orleans favorites. And now, the new banquet room is open for private parties and events. Let's toast the sunset and feel the lake breeze, just like old times. The Blue Crab Restaurant and Oyster Bar on Lakeshore Drive, where West End meets the lake. Open for lunch and dinner, Tuesdays through Sundays.
Bobby Hebert here with Bold Ford. This January, get the new Ford you've been looking for at Bold Ford during the Let It Ride sales event. We're kicking off the new year with incredible savings on over 425 new Ford.